Hello students, so in this video we are going to discuss about another property of acid, that is reaction of dilute acid with metal carbonate or bicarbonate. So as you can see in the figure, here is a test tube fixed in a stand and a thistle funnel is immersed in it. Here we have taken some sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate also can be taken, and slowly some dilute acid should be added to it. Now in this part of the tube has been fixed in a test tube containing some fresh lime water. Lime water is your clear solution of calcium hydroxide. Now on adding, but before you just see, this thistle funnel is immersed inside the solution. Okay, so here the sodium carbonate is taken and then through this the acid is added, maybe dilute hydrochloric acid or dilute sulfuric acid can be taken, and the tube should be immersed inside. To that extent the acid should be added, and after adding the acid to this sodium carbonate, you will find that a brisk effervescence, we can say. That is, the rapid bubbling occurs and the bubbles started escaping through this tube and it will be passed through this lime water. So you find that these bubbles, as soon as passing through this lime water, the lime water turns milky. Okay, it started turning milky. Now here the reaction is taking place. You can see sodium carbonate reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid, sodium chloride, water and carbon dioxide is produced. And so from this tube carbon dioxide is passing through, and when carbon dioxide passes through lime water, you can say that it produces calcium carbonate and water. So the milkiness is due to the formation of insoluble calcium carbonate. Now, if the gas will be passed in excess, that means through this, if you pass the gas in excess, that means carbon dioxide passing through CaCO3 plus H2O, then you will find a soluble product, calcium bicarbonate. Calcium bicarbonate will be produced. That is why it is soluble in nature. Okay, so the milkiness disappears on adding the gas in excess. So whenever acid reacts with metal carbonate or bicarbonate, then brisk effervescence occur. The observation will be that the brisk effervescence occur with the evolution of a colorless, odorless gas which turns lime water milky. On passing the gas in excess, the milkiness disappear. So any carbonate you can take or any bicarbonate you can take. Suppose instead of sodium carbonate, I will take a bicarbonate, say NaHCO3. Sodium bicarbonate. Now on passing, suppose dilute hydrochloric acid, you can see the same product produced. NaCl, water and carbon dioxide. So reaction of acid with metal carbonate and bicarbonate liberate carbon dioxide gas which turns lime water milky. Okay, this is your second property of the acid, that is reaction of metal carbonate or bicarbonate with acid. So first one we have discussed about reaction of acid with metal. Okay, reaction of acid with metal, in that case hydrogen gas evolved. Wherever reaction possible, active metals react. And in this case, metal carbonate or bicarbonate you take. Even in solid state you can take, not that the solution is required. In that, if you will pass your dilute acid, maybe hydrochloric acid, maybe sulfuric acid, maybe your nitric acid. Whatever acids will pass, then it liberate carbon dioxide gas.
and the gas turns lime water milky. The same mechanism. Remember, the similar mechanism is used in your soda acid fire extinguisher, where sulfuric acid and sodium bicarbonate are being contained in that cylinder. So sodium bicarbonate is there, and in that one test tube will be there, a small glass tube will be there fitted with a piston. In that some acid will be there. So when the piston is pressed, the acid reacts with that your sodium bicarbonate. So the rapid evolution of carbon dioxide gas is being produced, which is shown near the fire, and carbon dioxide covers it to extinguish the flame. So soda acid fire extinguisher based on this reaction mechanism. Okay, thank you.